Can you really hate a tarantula? Hello, tarantula lovers. I'm Alex and you're watching Tarantula Haven. Today we're talking about one of the most hated tarantulas in the hobby, or at least one that people love to hate, and that is the Lasiodora Parahybana, commonly known as the Salmon Pink Bird Eater. More about why people love to hate this tarantula so much in a little bit, but before I get into that, I have a couple of items of mail that I would like to open up. One of them I've been holding on to for almost a week now, and I'm really anxious to open it up because I know what it is, but I've kind of forgotten everything that's in it, and there are a couple of surprises in there, so I really want to find out what that is, and you may even know what it is because other tarantula YouTubers have been getting them as well, and yeah, that's one thing that I want to open up. But the other one is something that a subscriber, one of my patrons, sent to me, and it is a gift from her, and it just arrived today, and I am really anxious to know what it is, so I want to share that with you as well. If you want to jump straight to the tarantulas, I will post a time jump link so that you can jump straight to the tarantulas in the description, and you don't have to watch all the opening of the mail if that's just not something you're interested in. So on with the unboxing, or the mail opening. The first item came in this lovely green packaging, and I'm sure you probably know what it is. It came all the way from the UK, and I'm gonna go ahead and open that up. Alright, so we got a shirt. Come on. There we go. Hold on. Oh yeah, you know I love my shirts. So yeah, this is the Keeper Cards. This is my first time ever participating in a Kickstarter program, so I didn't really know what I was doing, but I thought it was pretty fun to help a friend out and to get these things out so people can enjoy them. And what is this? Oh, very cool. Is this like this is a tea towel. Very cool. Oh, and I'm holding it upside down. So it came with a tea towel, and it's got a little tarantula on there, and it's got, I think, the anatomy, the dorsal view, and the ventral view from the Keeper Cards. Very cool. Like, that'll come in handy. I can use that here in the tarantula room. And a big thank you letter, and I'm not going to get into all that. All right. Oh, lots of stuff inside the box here. So let's get that out. Let's take a look at all the goodies we have inside. We got a Keeper's Creepers bracelet. Couple of Keeper's Creepers buttons. Keeper's Creepers magnet. Yep, magnet and sticker. Oh, and this is really cool. This is a Kickstarter exclusive card. The H. Deva Matha. The Andrew Smith Holo Pack. And we'll see what's inside there. There's a Psilotheria Hanumavilla Sumika. That's fun to say. And the Kickstarter exclusive card, the Salmopius Victori. I need to get one of those. And of course, the Keeper Cards themselves. So the Keeper Cards. Oh, just a little card in there. And they always come in this neat little bag. And, of course, the Keeper Cards in there. And this is the Big, the Bad, and the Bold expansion pack. So we got Tarantula History 101, Love Tarantulas, Molting, all kinds of stuff. And we got all kinds of different pictures and information about tarantulas. And I'm not going to go through the whole thing and bore you, but if you would like to get your own, you can.
So that was the Big, the Bad, and the Bold expansion pack. And these are the keeper cards. There's the original keeper cards. And then, of course, there's the expansion pack. And I hope he makes some more expansion packs in the near future. But I believe that you can still purchase the original pack. And I think the new expansion packs will also be available on his website. So very cool stuff. It was pretty fun to be part of this Kickstarter. And it took a little while, but I finally got everything in. And it was pretty cool. I can't wait to get into these holo packs and see what all they are. And enjoy these things and just look at them and read them and all that. But it's a really neat thing. And if you want your own, I'll post a link down below in the description so you can get your own stuff. This next one is kind of a big box. I have no idea what it is. This was sent to me by one of my patrons. Her name is Cindy Ward. And she asked me if I had a P.O. box and she'd like to send me something. And I don't have a P.O. box. I should get one, I guess. But it's just more money that I have to spend. So I just had her send it to my house. And I'm anxious. I'm curious to find out what it is. I know that she is crafty and she does stuff on Etsy, I believe. So if there's any information that goes along with that, I'll post that as well because she makes some really cool stuff that I've seen online, but I really don't know anything about what is inside. So I'm really curious to find out. So let's go ahead and open this up and find out. Close this up. I always poke myself with X-Acto knives. I never fail, so make sure I keep that little safety cap. All right, what's in here? Got some stickers and, oh, cool. Yeah, her little Etsy shop is Memories of Violet. And it says crochet and crafts. So let's see what's in here. So she has a little note in here. It says, "Dear Alex, I just want to let you know that we really enjoy your YouTube channel. I can tell you really enjoy teaching and it shows in your videos. Keep up all the good work. I decided to throw a few things together for you while I'm working on orders. I hope you enjoy." And she gives me a list of the contents and I'll show that to you in just a second. And she gives her name or her shop name. It is Memories of Violet. And she started it as a just a crochet Etsy shop. And it's named after her grandmother who taught her all about crochet and has expanded into so much more. If anyone wants to know how to contact her, she has her Facebook page. And of course, I'll put her Etsy shop on there as well. She says, "From one tarantula, heavy metal, and horror movie lover to another." Thank you so much, Cindy. I really appreciate that. I've been catching a lot of flack on my music lately. I guess my choice of music hasn't been all that great. Some people like it soft. Some people like it hard. I kind of like both. I have a pretty eclectic taste in music. It jumps back and forth. Sometimes I like mellow stuff, and sometimes I like the harder stuff. But I try to fit the music to whatever the situation is. They didn't really like that OBT music. It's a lot more metal. Alternative. Oh, wow. Got some decals here. Two tarantula decals. Those are really cool. Put those on the car window or something. They're neat. Wow, there's a lot of stuff in here. What else? This. Have to be careful not to cut anything. All right, some kind of frame thing. Oh, it is a canvas-like picture of a Salmopius cambridgii. Very cool. Looks like Meg Mucklebones. Is that Meg Mucklebones? What is it? Another picture thing. All right, what is this one? And an OBT. Those are cool. All right. And you know I love my t-shirts. What does this t-shirt say? Have you seen my pet tarantula? Yeah, definitely wear that around. Oh my goodness, there's just all kinds of stuff. I just look for an excuse to talk about my tarantulas. Oh, very cool. Have a Merry Christmas, and it's got Meg Mucklebones on there, so definitely going on the Christmas tree next year. Oh! She remembered Dobby. And these are some little cat toys. She hasn't met Maggie. Maggie loves to swat these things around, and so does Max. But Dobby was the cat that got bitten by the water moccasin. Fortunately, did okay. And I'm opening this up. Little crochet green bottle blue there. I'm assuming it looks like a green bottle blue. There's one more thing in here. Remove this out of the way. Oh, coffee mug. And we got tarantulas all over it. We got green bottle blues. It looks like a golden blue leg. Meg Mucklebones right there. Very nice. Like my coffee in the morning. Thank you so much, Cindy. That is awesome. These things are great. I really appreciate the gift. Thank you so much. I will post a link down below for her Etsy shop and her Facebook so that you can get in contact with her if you are interested in any of the crafts that she does. She makes cups and she makes all kinds of cool stuff. It's really neat. So definitely check her out. Oh my gosh, I didn't realize that the cat toys had catnip in them. We went and gave them to the cats just now and they're going nuts over them. Stick around till the end and I've got a little bit of footage of them going stupid over the catnip. All right, so I am rehousing my LP today, and the reason that I'm doing that is because she is in a 30 long aquarium. It's actually a reptile cage and it's got a screen lid, and she does like to wander around, and sometimes she gets up on that screen lid and she has been dangling from it lately. So I'm worried about her well-being. I don't want her to get stuck up there. Not to mention she has a lot of space, and sometimes she does roam in that space, but for the most part she only occupies about this much of it. She usually stays around her hide that she has, and I figured that I could downsize her to a 10-gallon aquarium and it would take up less space on my shelf over here and make room for a little bit more stuff, because I'm getting a little overcrowded in here and I have kind of been on a freeze of new tarantulas because I don't want to overcrowd myself. I just don't have the space for them, and I've just stopped buying tarantulas for the time being until I can maybe send off some mails and make a little bit more room and so on. So that's the reason for the topic today. Now, why do people love to hate the Lasiodora Parahybana? Well, let's get into it. Lasiodora Parahybana, commonly known as the salmon pink bird eater or just the LP. It is endemic to northern Brazil. They are among the giants of tarantulas and has been considered the fourth largest tarantula after the Theraphosa blondii, Stermi, and Apophysis. They are reported to have leg spans of up to 11 inches, but 8 or 9 is probably more realistic, and I have yet to see a 10-inch specimen. Females will live to about 15 years, while males will only live about 4. This is a fast-growing species and can reach leg spans of up to 4 inches in a year and adult sizes in 2 years. As spiderlings, they will burrow, but as they get larger, they will spend more and more time outside of the burrow and will prefer a hide in which to retreat, but will pretty much stay out in the open most of the time. Mine is active and likes to roam around the enclosure, laying down a mat of webbing everywhere she goes. This is a bold tarantula that will venture out to challenge you if you are poking about the enclosure. Part of this is due to their aggressive food drive. They will pounce on pretty much anything that lands in front of them that they perceive as prey. I once reached in with my tongs to pull out a bolus when she pounced and attacked the tongs to my surprise. While not defensive, great care must be taken to not be mistaken for food if you put your hand in the enclosure. LPs are very hardy and tolerant of different conditions. As spiderlings and juveniles, I kept the enclosure relatively damp. As adults, I kept it on the drier side with a water dish. They also do very well at room temperature. So why do people love to hate on the Lasiodora Parahybana? For one, they possess terrible urticating hairs and will not hesitate to use them, especially as juveniles. They also lay them around everywhere in the enclosure, so just simply messing about the enclosure can lead you to getting urticating hairs on you. However, I believe the real reason is because they are so common. Lasiodora Parahybana have been referred to as the poor man's Goliath bird eater. They are easy to breed, and their egg sacs often contain upwards of 1,000 and often 2,000 or more spiderlings. Because there is no shortage of LPs, the price on this impressive species is usually very low. I paid about $20 each for mine, but I've seen them as low as $10. People have a tendency to want to gravitate to the largest, the rarest, the most beautiful, and fail to appreciate the beauty of this species. Personally, I find them more beautiful, just as impressive, and easier to keep than the Theraphosis. I would absolutely recommend this as a beginner species with the understanding that great care has to be taken to avoid those urticating hairs.
That went a whole lot better than I expected. She was very well behaved for me. I liked the smaller enclosure. Even though she had a whole lot more room to roam around, it just made it too bulky, too cumbersome, and it was hard for me to deal with and get in there. I have it down here on the bottom shelf, so I ended up neglecting it because of that, and of course, that's something you don't want to do. So having it in a smaller enclosure will make it a lot easier for me to get into and mess with it and do what I have to do and take care of those plants so that they don't die out, and take care of her as well. Now, she's not neglected. She's fat. I would drop roaches in there and put water in there, but the plant suffered because they were further back and it was hard for me to pull it out and water everything and take care of everything. So this will make it a whole lot easier because it's smaller and easier to maneuver. As far as her behavior, she was very well behaved. She didn't kick any urticating hairs at me. I was actually wanting her to so that I can capture that on video, but she did not. And, you know, she's full of surprises. Most of the time when I mess around in the enclosure, she will kick up a whole bunch of urticating hairs, or she'll attack the tongs or whatever I'm using to manipulate stuff in there. And, you know, she was really, really well behaved. I was just surprised. So she did exactly what I wanted. She walked around. It was very easy to record her, but unfortunately it wasn't as exciting as I wanted it to be. But that's good for me though, because normally she would have
had urticating hairs on my arms and I'd have been real itchy, but just messing around in the enclosure and having her out, I still got a little bit itchy. But fortunately for me, I'm not real susceptible to the urticating hairs. And there are some people that will welt up. They'll even develop pustules and things like that from the urticating hairs. That's how bad they are. Now, I could develop a sensitivity later on down the road. That does happen to people, but hopefully it won't for me. And, I'll keep her and take care of her for years to come. I will tell you that I do recommend the Lasiodora Parahybana as a good beginner species for a responsible keeper. I wouldn't recommend it for children, and I wouldn't recommend it for someone who likes to hold their pets. They are capable of great bursts of speed, they will bolt, and those urticating hairs are nothing to joke around with. They are pretty bad, especially if they get in your nose, mouth, or eyes. You can develop some really bad problems from that. Their venom is not exactly potent, but the mechanical bite, that is something that you do have to worry about. If you have seen those fangs, you would worry about that. And I even had the urge to hold her today because she was so well behaved. But just knowing and seeing those fangs and hearing that crunch when they bite into something, it just dissuaded me completely from doing that. It brought me back to my senses. But a lot of people do hold them. They can be docile, but just be warned that there are certain things that you have to worry about. Do I hate my LP? No, I love her. I think that she is awesome, and I think that she is an impressive girl. My kids loved her when she was in the classroom. So yeah, it's just one of those species that people love to hate, and there are more of them. There are plenty that people love to hate, and a lot of them are your more common species, and simply because they are so common. But that is a good thing for you, especially if you want an impressive tarantula that gets to a good size really fast. The LP is definitely one to look into. And as far as I'm concerned, they are a lot easier to keep than your Theraphosa species. Before I go, I'd like to give a huge thank you to Keeper Cards. Thank you so much. Just a quick reminder, if you want some of your own, there is a link down below in the description where you can buy your own Keeper Cards. Thank you so much to Cindy Ward for the wonderful gifts. I really appreciate it. I love them. My cats love them. And don't forget to check out Memories of Violet. And I will post a link down below to her Etsy and her Facebook page. And that does it for me tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. If you want to support this channel, I have a Teespring store where I sell Tarantula Haven merchandise. Thank you so much to my Patreon supporters like Cindy Ward. And thank you so much to Matthew Gonzalez, my newest patron. Your support is greatly appreciated. And as always, keep loving them tarantulas.